Next question is from M.J. Langevin. If we're not necessarily chasing soreness in our program in order to train more frequently, how do we know if we're tearing the muscles enough to ensure growth?
I like this question because I think that I was guilty of perpetuating this, right? Telling people that we tear and break down in the gym, and then it's when you go home, you rest, repair, and grow. Because there's a little bit of truth to that, but it's not as important as you think. You can never get sore, and you can consistently build muscle and burn body fat.
That's right.
You can never ever get sore and feel. I mean, in fact, the most ultimate. I've actually thought about doing this too, of like, you know, being so consistent for like 6 months to a year, where I barely progressively overload consistently. Mm-hmm. You see this like with people who get really good at like push-ups, like they start with 10 push-ups and then they add to 11, then they add to 12. I mean, you can progressively overload just a tiny bit to where you don't even really get sore, but the body adapts and gets stronger because you're overloading. And honestly, that's your best indicator that you're doing well in your programming. If you never get sore, but your strength is going up, mm-hmm. you are doing beautifully. Now, it's very normal to overreach sometimes because you're excited about that workout, or you had a pre-workout, or you overreach a little bit, or you felt strong that day, so you did a little a little much, so you feel a little sore the next day. So yeah, you overreached a little bit, not the end of the world. But chasing the feeling of soreness as an indicator of your programming is doing well is a terrible indicator of that.
Now, soreness is a better indicator to tell you that you might have done too much. If you're really sore, if it lasts longer than a day or two, you probably went too hard or did too much for whatever the context of that day was. Otherwise, it's a terrible indicator of progress. The best indicator of progress is progress, right? Mm-hmm. So stronger, building muscle. Am I progressing? Yes, your progress is showing that. As far as tearing muscles down is concerned, adaptation is the process by which your body builds muscle and gets you stronger. Healing is just healing the damage that was caused, right? Yeah. So you can heal and never adapt. In fact, a lot of people do this when they work out. They have such terrible programming, or maybe they over-apply intensity, and they get sore, then the soreness goes away, and they go back to the gym and repeat again, mm-hmm. and yet they don't ever progress. And what they're doing is they're just breaking, surviving. They're just breaking down and healing.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's the thing. I feel like this is such a common struggle for athletes and for people that are like really like putting a lot of mental discipline into their workouts in terms of like overcoming all the stress and like, you know, if I could push through, that means I'm progressing. And so to not have an indicator of soreness feels like, well, that's pathetic. You know, that's mm-hmm. something that was beneath my abilities. And so I should always be pressing my body to its limits. But you just don't reap the benefits that you could if you were just more intelligent about the way you approach it. And it is tough. It's tough to kind of reframe that in your mind. Was something I struggled with, you know, initially, because it was just like all or nothing was just pounded into my head. So it's just, you just got to kind of check that, you know, mentally and try it, like trust the process, like go through that. You will find how much stronger you get and it's going to happen more rapidly.
If you're adding sets, adding reps, or adding weight to the bar over time, following a program and never get sore, you are crushing. Like, that is the perfect yep. place to be. The reality is, though, you're not always going to be adding weight or adding sets or and adding reps, and sometimes you're going to get a little sore. But if you're not getting sore, but you have the ability to do another set than what you did the previous week, or 5 more pounds on the bar than you did the previous week, you are progressing, and you are doing it perfectly if you are able to do that without feeling really sore. So that's where I'm always seeking for that. And the reality is I overreach a lot and end up going like, ah, shit, I didn't need to do that much. But if you can actually continue to see weight increase, sets increase, or reps, any of those, all those are forms of progressively overloading the body. If you're able to do any of those or all of those over the course of weeks or months, you are progressing incredibly. And if you're able to do that and never get sore, you're a champion.